everyone. Welcome to my channel. This is Gurpreet from DataWiz Canvas. And in today's session, we are going to learn about how to use satellite or orbit chart to represent a percentage. We normally use pie chart or gate chart to represent percentage, but in today's session, we are going to learn a different way to represent the percentage. For this, we'll be using data densification technique and we'll be using a sample superstore dataset. So without any further delays, let's jump straight into Tableau Desktop. For this, we'll be connecting to sample superstore dataset, and I have already downloaded the Excel spreadsheet for that. So you can connect it either from the saved data sources. I will use Microsoft Excel in this case. So I will connect to sample superstore dataset by just clicking on the file, and I will drag orders into the data shelf, and I will open the order table. And I will add another Excel file which have path values in it. So what is in the path value? So I will quickly show you the Excel spreadsheet. So it has the values from 0 to 360. So what we are trying to do here is we are trying to create points artificially between 0 and 360 for each record. So when we create a join with this path table, so what it is doing is it's creating two records for each existing order in the table. And in the join condition, I will use a Cartesian join by just putting one in the join condition on both the tables. So once that is done, you will see the data is populated at the bottom, and you will see for each record there are two values, two records exactly duplicated, but the path field have two separate values, 0 and 360. And we'll be using data densification technique to artificially create points between 0 and 360 for each record. Let's see how to do that. So let's go into the sheet one. And first of all, we will create a bin on the path fields with the size of 1. And then we will be creating an index calculation where I will just type an index function minus 1. So this will give us the value starting from 0. And then I will create x coordinates, and I will type in cos of radians of index. And same way, I will create a calculation for y coordinate, which will be sine of radians of index. So you must be wondering how I created these calculations for x and y coordinate. So let's have a quick look. So as I mentioned in my previous tutorial, we are using this equation, standard equation of a circle, which is x minus h square plus y minus k square equal to r square, where h and k is the center point of the circle and r is the radius. And x and y is any point on the circumference of the circle. And for that, we need to figure out a equation of x and y coordinate. So in this case, we'll be using a trigonometrical function as we have a right angle triangle here and an angle of theta in between these right angle triangle. So we'll be using that. So sine of theta is equal to y upon r, which is perpendicular over hypotenuse. And the same way, cos of theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse, which is x upon r. So using those calculations, we will say x is equal to r into cos theta and y equal to r into sine theta. And for this example, we will be using r to start with as 1. So then y will be equal to sine theta and x will be equal to cos theta. So if we go back to our calculation here and added that, you will see x is equal to cos theta. So in this case, we converted the degrees into radian for each of the index values. And now we will simply bring segment into column shelf and y into column shelf as well and x into column shelf, and we'll bring path into details, and I will right click on these coordinates and we'll say compute using path pen, and same we'll do it for the y axis, and you will see the circle started to appear. And then we'll bring the segment into color shelf to color code each of these segments separately. And let's change the mark to line. And when we do that, this thing will appear, which doesn't make sense because Tableau doesn't understand which points to join. So then we will bring this path bin into path shell, and you will see the circles are created. Great. So now, in order to create an orbit or satellite shard based on the values of the sail, we will create a few more calculations. So the first calculation I will be creating is for sails. And here we will be using window sum, and we will do sum of sails. And once we have that, sum of sails, once we have that, we will divide it by 2. Why we are doing that? Because when we joined it with the paths table, we are creating two rows, two duplicate rows basically, for one with 0 value and one with 360 value. We need only one row to get the sum of sails, so we divided it by 2. Same way, we'll be creating another calculation for total sails, and we'll use the same window sum calculation, and we will do sum of sails again and divide it by 2. It's exactly the same calculation, but when we are going to use the table calculation, we will simply using different dimensions on which it is calculated. So for example, what we are trying to achieve here is, like for consumer, I want to know sales by consumer, and then in order to get the percentage of total sales in all these three segments, I'll be using that sum of sales of consumer divided by sum of total sales for all these three segments together in order to get the percentage. So I will create another calculation for percentage field, where I will say sales divided by total sales. There you go. I click on that, and once we have the percentage, we will now create another calculation for size. So size of the orbit, right? So for that, we will say if index calculation, which we created, if index divided by Windows max of index value, which we created. So what we are saying here is, if the index value is, let's say, 90, because we have created 0 to 360 points between 0 to 360, and if we say there is a point in between, let's say, 90, so that's the index value. So 90 divided by the Windows max value of index, which is 360 in this case. So 90 divided by 360 is equal to 1 by 4, which is 25%. If that value is greater than our percentage value, which we created, right? Then give me 1, else give me 0, and, right? So did I miss something here? Oh, there's a gap, right? So that makes sense. So that's what it is saying here. So that's our size calculation. And so it's actually, you can do it either way. So less than or greater than. So if you do greater than, your VAS value will be created on this side. So let's do it less than, because we want to show the percentage on the lesser side. So we'll click OK here. I will show you in a second what it means. So let's bring the size to the size bar, and you will see here small dot is created. So let's change it and say compute using path bin. And once you do that, it will look something like this. And then we want to do edit table calculation, and we'll go to total sales, and we'll select segment here. There you go. It started looking much better now. And you will see what I meant here by size value. So we are index value divided by maximum index value. In this case, we were saying, so if you look at consumer example, so if you hover over to these values, you will see the size is 1. And I'm saying if the percentage is less than this, then give me 1. And if you go here, it is 0. So that's how we plot the percentage here. So now these charts are created. So let's do a bit of formatting here. So I don't need the headers. I will remove all the headers. And before I do that, actually, let's go one step back. We'll do Control Z. Create another calculation just to do a bit more formatting, and I will say 0. Click OK, and I will bring 0 into the row shell, and I will create dual axis here, and I will synchronize the axis, Once that is done, I will just remove the headers. And I don't need any of the lines here, grid lines. I will just remove all these lines from here. We don't need any of these. And it will look much better after this. And when I go to the borders, I don't need dividers. So it will look something like this. Then I will increase the size just to the desired one, whichever we need. And I will change the center one to text. And in here, I don't need segment and I don't need measure name. And I will bring sales into the text span, and I will bring segments into the text as well. And I will remove this and sales into the text section here. Oh, so it's selected to map. I don't need map. I wanted to do text. See, you can see here it looks much better now. And I will remove the segment and will remove it from here and remove the headers, and it will look something like this. And you can do a bit more formatting here by just going into here, and in the segments you can make it a bit larger and click OK. And in terms of sales, you can format it and you can do the formatting, and let's say currency and zero decimal places, and I would say millions. And even if you want to bring the percentage, just bring the percentage into the shelf here and change the formatting of percentage. And let's say percentage to one decimal place, looks much better. And you can go here and let's say I want it all in one row. I will just select that and do a bit more formatting and change the color to, let's say, a bit lighter in this case, and click OK. And it will look something like this. And you can see consumer is 50%. Corporate is 30.7% and home office is 8.7%. So that's how you create orbit chart or satellite chart and use it to show the percentage value, and it looks quite decent, I would say. Hope you guys enjoyed this session, and if you have any questions, please feel free to drop me a message or share the comments below. Thank you. See you next time. Bye.